Welcome back to the Make or Break Society. In this one, I'm going to show you how to install the Compute Module 5 into the PSPi version 6. Just a quick reminder that I am giving away two PSPis with the CM4 installed. Scan the QR code, click the card, or check the link in the description to be taken to the video that has all the details. Now with that out of the way, let's get into it. We're going to start by first removing the CM4 that is already installed. Step 1 is to remove the UMD cover using something thin and flat like this spudger. Slide it into the left side and gently pry it off. Now most of you likely have the carrier screwed in, but I don't because I do this kind of stuff often. Now remove and set aside the SD card and rock the carrier board back and forth until it comes out. Next, remove the Wi-Fi connector and thermal pad. I'm just going to put the thermal pad onto the CM5 for now. Now remove the CM4 using the spudger to gently pry it up from the screw holes. Next, install the CM5. It generally goes in with the writing opposite to the writing on the carrier board. Make sure you line up the holes and then check that your ZIF connectors are lined up. Then just press the CM5 down firmly until you hear both connectors click. Then go back and push down each side again just to make sure everything's connected properly. Next, connect your Wi-Fi connector and reinstall the carrier board, making sure that the Wi-Fi cable does not get between the Pi and the main board. Now you can reinstall the UMD cover, being careful on the left side not to break that clip. It can snap easily. Now we're going to pop over to the computer and flash the SD card. Alright, to get RetroPie installed, you're going to need to download two things. First, you're going to need to download and install the Raspberry Pi Imager. If you don't have it already, so you can download for Windows, macOS. I already have it installed, so I'm not going to download it. I will leave the link for where to get this in the description, but it's raspberrypi.com/software. The other thing you're going to need is we are going to need to download the customized operating system from Other Mod's GitHub. Now, Other Mod didn't make this version of it, but it's easiest, it's linked through here. The first thing we're going to do, we're going to scroll down into the Getting Started on the Operating Systems Wiki page. You can see all the operating systems we have to choose from. We're going to grab the one from Koza. See, he's got ones for pretty much everything. CM5 ones listed here. We'll go down and down and down into the assets. Now, what we're looking for is there's a PiOS RetroPie. So there's another one here. And you can see there's the RetroPie one here. Don't use these ones. Go up here to the PiOS. Up here to the PiOS.RetroPie. So you grab this one here. We don't need the checksum. If you have errors, maybe use the checksum to make sure there's not a problem with yours. But we're going to download this one here. Now that that's done, we're going to close this and pop over to the imager. So now that we're in the imager, we're going to choose OS. We're going to click Use Custom, and in the window that pops up, select the image you want to use, which is the one we just downloaded, and click Open. Click Choose Storage, select the device, and click Next. We would like to apply OS customizations. We need to do this. It is an absolute must. Configure wireless LAN and make sure you set up your Wi-Fi correctly right now. If we don't set up this properly, the installer won't work, as the image we're flashing is just Raspberry Pi OS with Raspberry Pi OS Lite with a script that runs the RetroPie installer. We select our region, and that's everything. We click Save, and then click Yes. Yes, I know it's going to erase all data, and let it go. Now with that done, we can just click Continue and remove our SD card. And we're going to install it now into our PSPi. Now back at our PSPi, we can install our SD card. After the SD card's installed, we're going to plug in power, as this install takes a while and the CM5 drains the battery really fast. Now we're just going to turn it on and let it go for a bit. I cut this off partway through because it adds like 10 minutes to this video, because it actually ends up taking like 2 hours. So even fast forwarding real fast is just a waste of time and not much to see. When it boots up, you'll see GamePad detected, so just hold a button on the controller to begin setup. Press and hold any button to skip that input for buttons the PSPi doesn't have. And that's it for part one. In part two, we'll be doing some thermal and performance testing. Make sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss part two. Also remember that I'm giving away 2 PSPis with the CM4, so check out that video for details. Until next time, remember, it doesn't matter if you make a break, so long as you're having fun.